back with more styrene excitement. This one is number 4 of the 6 Trick Trike series, 1/25th scale, Milk Trike. Check that out. Awesome retro box art on there. Gives you a lot of ideas. Tells you all the details of the kit and all the extras you can expect. So this is an awesome design. I've had such a blast building the other 3. I'm glad we're going to get to build these last 3. Number 4, I don't know what 5 and 6 are. I'm sure the experts on the kits will know. But let me show you everything that's going to be in the Milk Trike when you get yours. First up will be the white styrene. And this one's got an extra large body compared to all the other ones I've built. This one seems much more substantially sized, which is going to be pretty cool to build it up. It's supposed to look like a milk wagon, and it certainly does, like the old horse-drawn type. We got this diamond pattern tufted seat in there. That's really cool. We got mounts for the lights. We've got our wheel backs here. Being a trike, it's got 2 large rear wheels. On this tree, this one is V8 powered. This thing must go so fast it goes back in time. A 4-cylinder motorcycle engine would move this thing out. This thing's got a small block under the hood. Not even to have a hood, just in there. Massive size with the transmission attached. Heads, intake, we can have some detailing fun with that. There is a gigantic multi-part chrome tree on this one. Look at the forks coming out. They're really forking huge. All nice in one piece, then we'll detail it. On either side, we've got our pedals here. We've got velocity stacks for the V8. Little black wash inside there will make them look real nice. We got our spoke front wheel. We got our mag rear wheels molded wide open. The chrome is beautiful on this. We've got fin valve covers, chrome oil pan, chrome differential. We've got our headers, one piece coming off each side. We've got our headlights, tail lights, and all kinds of extra details on there. Like I said, especially like that long single piece fork on there, makes it a lot easier. Let's go to the other side of the desk. There isn't a massive amount of stuff in the box because it's a trike. It doesn't need it. 3 different shades of clear parts. We got orange, clear, and purple. Decide how you want to decorate your kit. This little steel axle is just floating around the box. Be careful when you open yours. You don't lose that. We've got skinny little Pirelli tire for the front end of the trike. We've got 2 beautiful hollow MH Racemaster tires on the back. Nice, soft, easy to put on the wheels after assembly. And Milk Trike logos on the inside. Graphics for that. Each tire has it. They look awesome on there, so you can either have Race Masters or you can go with the Milk Trike look and get those cool white letter, white wall tires on the side. We have a gigantic decal sheet, beautiful clear. We've got bubbles going on. We've got Cream Cycle. We've got the Milk logos, Pop Machine, Ice Machine. We've got the cross there. We've got some creamsicles on the side. We've got, what do these ones say here? Cold, delicious soda. You think you're cold. Keep on trucking. High velocity. We've got some stripes for the cab. We've got some tufted pattern for the seat. We've got more stripes here. We've got some cross with the flame. We've got some small license plate. We got Milk It For All You Can in white letters right there. Talk about an extensive decal sheet. Look at that. We'll get that as close as we can, all in one. A lot of stuff on there that's going to be left over. I'm going to start to build mine. We'll be right back. Assembly on these always goes super easy. You've seen me build enough of them and the variations. They usually use a lot of the same chrome parts on them, and then they'll vary in the seats and the body style and the decals, of course. We got the mounts for our lights that'll be going on the forks and on the back of the body there. So the way we'll attach that is we will paint that body color and then glue it on with super glue. When I glue the chrome parts together that need work, for the fork, I just use dollar store super glue. Works perfectly with a little bit of activator that's squirted in there, and that gets those together. If you get a little cloudiness on your chrome parts, you can see I got a little bit of cloudiness there. A coat of future floor polish at the end will get rid of that immediately for you, and it'll disappear. Now, as far as the front wheel, the axle, and the two lanterns go, I sanded those down so that the surfaces that touch are actual plastic, and then I use model glue to hold those together. The front wheel, you can just see it's a little rough on the edges, but that doesn't matter because the wheel itself is beautiful chrome, and I'll be able to just attach that into the fork after I push the tire over it. So we're all set with that. We don't need to do anything with that. The axles and the lanterns, I always want to repaint those anyways, so I'm not careful at all. I'd rather have them glued solidly than be glued loosely, so I use the model glue with those. We'll be repainting those anyways. The seat and the wheel backs, I want to be body color. We got that beautiful seat decal that we can put over here when we're done, or I can hand paint it. I'll decide where I go there, but I want the floor and that surrounding area body color as well as the entire underneath and everything, so we'll make it easy, leave those on the same tree. The engine transmission is set to go. You can see I don't have the valve covers on it, and everything is pretty much molded in on that one, the timing chain cover and everything. There is no belt and pulley system or fan or anything, very rudimentary. We've got all the chrome parts that I'll be putting on later, the valve covers, the oil pan. We've got the headers, and we've got all those nice velocity stacks, all 8 of them there. So those are going to stay chrome. We're going to leave those alone. I'll get this painted up. The body itself goes together super easily, lines up real nice. Now, I don't spend a lot of time. I give it a swipe with a sanding stick, and that's it. But I don't spend any time worrying about seams. Doesn't bother me at all, but if you want to remove those, go ahead, sand those flat, smooth them out, do your thing. You can glue the entire body together, and you can get the gauge package. See it underneath there? Right through there. You can get the gauge package in and glue that all solidly with model glue. Do not glue the neck together. If you glue the neck together, one, you're not going to get your engine to sit in these 4 pegs. Also, of course, you're never going to get your forks in. And then you'll be all forking mad. You'll see how those are going to go together. Just, you know, loosely pressing it together. It's going to make for a cool looking rig, like so. And it's nice and long. I mean, we can count it out 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 inches, which is a darn good size for a trike like that. So we are all set. The handlebars themselves, like I said, I just put together with super glue. You got the entire neck as one piece, and these nice little side arms on each one are then glued on, and there's very large locating pins for all of that to go together. You're not going to have any problems. I'm going to get this into paint. Now, this chrome stuff we're going to set on the side. I want to leave it chrome. The wheel we're going to set on the side. The rest of this we're going to get primered and get into some color. We'll be right back. The one thing I love about these trikes is they're so easy to work on, but they build a delicate looking model, yet it's not as hard to put together as it is so many times when you have small stuff. Now, the parts that we're gonna be putting together, the sub-assemblies, we've got the engine ready to go. We've got the little chrome parts all attached to it, the chrome oil pan, the transmission is painted, the valve covers. I even did little chrome trim rings around the injector stacks there. I did that, you know, you could paint the intake a different color, whatever you want, got the magneto on there. So we are all set to go. That's my little detailing. We will just clip off the injector stacks. I will touch up each side with a little bit of silver Sharpie where we cut them free, and we'll be able to glue those into place with little tiny dabs of super glue in there. The front fork is all ready to go. We've got the handlebars painted. We've got the headlight attached with its clear lens in that one. We've got the springs blackwashed. We've got the nuts and bolts on the side. All this needs is a brushed on coat of future floor polish to restore its shine from so much handling. And we'll be able to do that once the whole model is all done. We got the headers all set to go. I blacked out their tips with a black Sharpie. I touched up the cutoff areas with a silver Sharpie. And those are set. We've got our tail light ready to mount. I used the purple lens in the tail light. This is the taillight mount that goes on the side of the body in this access hole here, and it will mount off there, and then we just hang our light. We've got our differential ready to push in. That's been chromed with paint, and that is all set to go. It looks more like a real metal than a plastic chrome metal. The body is all set to go. I painted those the arms here, the trailing arms, and the differential mount a flat black. Got the body in its beautiful purple. Got that purple window mounted in with Mod Podge, the same way I did the headlights that you saw. So you know that's in there. And then I did that nice trim around each side opening. I really like how that adds some detail to the body. The interior, if you're going to call it that, is all set to go with that nice metallic black fabric looking vinyl seat. I did all the little buttons in there with a gel pen. You've seen me use those on numerous other reviews. Just a silver gel pen. You can Google them up. Got the gas pedal, brake, clutch, and shifter all in there. So that's going to look nice pushed inside. Got the wheel and tire package ready to go. You can mount them either way. I'm going to try to mount that directional so it looks like it's splattering like that around the outside. Or you can, of course, go with the MH Racemasters. Those wheels look awesome inside there. They look pretty darn delicious. They're yummy. With that black wash, it brings out their detail. They are great looking. And we got the front tire pushed together as well. I will decide what decals I want to use. Obviously, I'm probably going to end up going with the Milk decals and finding some other stuff on here to use to dress up the body a little bit. There's a lot of other details in white. There's some sayings here, milk it for all you can. Cold and fresh milk, fast delivery guaranteed. And we've got a lot of scroll work and diamond work that I could add to the body as well to give it a little bit of a detail since the sides and the fenders are so big. We've got it painted up in that beautiful Testors Purplicious. All I will do at this point is pretty much the engine pushes in, the differential pushes in, we've got to slide our axle in, we've got to clip our front fork in, attach the wheel, I will have to glue the headers on, I will have to glue the mount for the taillight, and then slide that down in there, and we'll be back for that final. All done with the Milk Trike front and center. You can see it going around on the turntable. We gave it a brushed on coat of future. You can see how awesome those Milk Trike tires look. And if you build anything else, you got the MH Racemasters. Milk it for all you can across the back. I cut that decal to fit across the back. There was an ice cream decal that talked about being utterly delicious. Well, that also goes for milk. So I cut that and put that on there. Use some of the diamond logos, use some of the cross logos on there, place them in different areas. I use the stripes to go down the roof of the vehicle. I spaced them differently so that the brighter lines were on the outside, and we are all set to go. So beautiful kit, easy to build, comes out awesome with that V8 and all the chrome parts on it. Absolutely love it and highly recommend it. Spinning in the back is the last trike I did. the Tiki Trike. You've seen me do the Mailbox Trike. You've seen me do the Taco Trike. And now we've got the awesome Milk Trike and two more to come. Very easy to build. I'm going to link in the description to where you can get yours, because I definitely think you should pick these up and build all six. I plan on building the other two. This one comes out lovely with that cockpit and the seat in there, the shifter and all the pedals. And even though it looks really, really delicate, it goes together super easy. So do all the other trikes. This one's got the four-cylinder motorcycle engine. This one's got the V8. They vary back and forth between the other two. I don't know if the other ones have more than that or less.
As always, build for you and don't let anyone bust your groove.
You've got all these cool decals on the sheet. Just amazing. You can do whatever you want with them. They look awesome. I was going to use the seat decal and cut it to fit, but I decided to go a different way with it. We've got these cool bubble effects for the pop machine, the cream cycle. You got so much cool stuff on there, and I just love this series. Coming up next, the next full build, here's a little hint. There's the tire from it. So you can kind of guess. Toss in the comments, you know what I'm got working on next, and that's going to take a while. But this is an absolute pleasure to build. You can get this all done in 24 to 48 hours without even trying hard at all. Comes out lovely and fits together so nice. Thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see you all at the next review.